25 years, the idea of home and identity has eluded the agenda audience today. We're coming to you live from Samavara, a place where Kashmiri Pandits get together every evening to talk about things which matter to them. And today, they're marking, many of them are protesting, the fact that 25 years later, there has been no resolution. We'll be speaking to all of them in just a bit, especially about the fact that with a new government, is there reason for hope or does despair still stand? But first, my colleague Zafar Iqbal brings you the story of those that went back in 2010.
At 22, the idea of home still eludes Sandeep. His family driven from the valley before he was born. All seven of them are now limited to this one room on the outskirts of Jammu. From here, the idea of return to Srinagar is tinged with fear of violence.
25 years jo bhi hue, isme kya hua ki har taraf nuksan hi hua, khaskar hamari community ka. Kyunki pehle to kisi ek jagah pe shift kiya, wahan pe stay kiya, wahan pe kitni problem aayi stay hone mein, wo to sab jante hain. उसके बाद दूसरी जगह पे शिफ्ट किया. यहाँ का एटमॉस्फेयर किसी को पता नहीं था कैसा है. अब जाके यहाँ पे भी सेट हो गए हैं थोड़ा थोड़ा, तो अब यहाँ से किसी दूसरी जगह शिफ्ट कर देंगे. तो मेन चीज़ जो होती है, जो पढ़ाई पे असर पड़ता है लोगों को.
हमारे अभी मोदी साहब ने कहा था कि कश्मीर ले जाएंगे, वहाँ पर जोनों में रहेंगे, सिक्योरिटी जोन में. मैं सही बता रहा हूँ कि हाँ ठीक है, सिक्योरिटी जोन में रहेंगे. एक हमने एक बच्चे को भेजना है स्कूल, वो 5 किलोमीटर दूर जाएगा, हमारी सिक्योरिटी पीछे तो नहीं रहेगी उसकी. तो वो कितनी हद तक चलेगी वो सिक्योरिटी, और कितना समय लगेगा सरकार को वो वातावरण बनाने में जैसे कि हम पहले रह रहे थे वहाँ पर.
If they were to see the fate of those who returned, they may not be as optimistic. More than the security concerns, it's the day-to-day problems which are most worrying. 1200 Pandits returned 5 years ago. They were given government jobs, they live in migrant camps, but do not have basic amenities like a ration card or even a voter ID card.
Mental torture hai, usko khatam karo. हमें आधार कार्ड है, इलेक्शन कार्ड है, एवरीथिंग, राशन कार्ड है. वहाँ पे अगर है थे पहले, हम ऐसा नहीं है कि पहले वहाँ पे नहीं थे, पहले जहाँ हम रहते थे वहाँ थे, अब हमें यहाँ चाहिए.
जो अब सोशल लाइफ में जाना जाता है या मैरिज हो रही है, जिनकी देखता हूँ मैं कि बहुत ही उनकी परेशानी हो रही है, क्योंकि फैमिली बढ़ रही है, स्टडी का इशू हो रहा है, बच्चों का इशू हो रहा है, अपने एल्डरली पेरेंट्स की ज्यादा चिंता होती है, जिन्होंने हमें 25 साल बड़ा किया और हम कुछ नहीं दे पाए उनको.
Now with the change of government at the center, there comes new hope of return and rehabilitation for the community.
अपने घर में वापसी जो है बहुत जरूरी है, और कश्मीर में कितने जनरेशन से रह रहे हैं ये लोग वहाँ पे, और यहाँ पे आप हम यहाँ पे इनको कोई भी सहूलत दे दें. देखिए, अपने घर का जो सुख है, मज़ा है, वो अपने घर का ही है. तो मैं यही प्रार्थना करूँगा कि हम राज्य सरकार की तरफ से भी और केंद्र सरकार की तरफ से भी, जो भाजपा है वो इस बारे में बहुत सीरियस है, और हम बिल्कुल चाहते हैं कि वो वापस जाएं.
सक्सेसिव गवर्नमेंट्स एट द सेंटर एंड द स्टेट हैव बीन सेइंग दैट दे वांट कश्मीरी पंडित्स बैक इन कश्मीर, बट 25 इयर्स आफ्टर दे लेफ्ट द वैली, देयर स्टिल नो टाइम बाउंड कॉन्क्रीट प्लान फॉर देयर रिटर्न. द क्वेश्चन दैट्स बीइंग आस्क्ड दैट व्हाट न्यू इनिशिएटिव्स विल नाउ बी मेड फॉर अ पीसफुल डिग्निफाइड रिटर्न ऑफ द कश्मीरी पंडित्स टू कश्मीर. इन श्रीनगर, जफर इकबाल फॉर एनडीटीवी.
So a lot of the people have been protesting today in Jantar Mantar and other parts as well. Let me just introduce the prominent speakers today. We have Siddhartha Giggo. He is a writer whose father, they've all been writing about. We also have Rashni Kher. He's a founder member of Roots in Kashmir, prominent in the protests. Sushil Pandit, CEO of an ad agency. He joins us here. And of course, giving us another perspective is Samir Arshad Khatlani, writer and journalist with the Times of India. And really, the first question, first talking point really is, what is it that 25 years later people are still protesting? Sushil Pandit, when you were standing, when you and Rashnik were standing in Jantar Mantar today, yesterday, what is it that you really want realistically from everyone?
Primarily from the system. A acknowledgement that an entire community was cleansed brutally out of their homes and lands, and this wasn't just a simple uprooting, it was a genocide. It was preceded by
most heinous crimes like rapes, murders, arson, abduction, terror. And when it was done, 25 years later, there is no judicial closure, there is no conviction, there is no sentencing, not one has been punished for it. 25 years later, there is no talk, there is no preparation, there is not even a plan that we could look at as part of the reversal of this genocide. Okay. Nobody is talking about it. People are treating it like some natural calamity and throwing some crumbs, some packages, some economic, some rehabilitation packages, and not looking at security issues. And much larger than that, nobody is looking at it as a malaise that has been plaguing larger parts of this country. Nobody sees it as an oncoming problem, not just in Kashmir, but elsewhere as well.
Okay, but Rushnik, if we look at it realistically, these are of course some issues that, you know, we've all seen, and we've seen some really evocative writing coming out today from many Kashmiri Pandits, some of whom are well-known journalists, writers. If you talk about realistically one or two things which would, as you say, mark the fact that this happened 25 years ago, what would they be?
Well, you know, I would obviously come to this, but I would also give you what, you know, what I will add to what Sushil just said. The most important thing, and in terms of doables, which the government can certainly do and should be doing, is one, they could punish at least one person for killings of Kashmiri Pandits. They say the number is 219, so be it, okay, even if it's 219, so be it. But have you punished anybody for these 219 people who got killed in Kashmir? There were almost 10,000, and it's a huge number, 10,000 Kashmiri Pandit houses were burnt, nobody got punished. There were hundreds of shrines destroyed, nobody got punished. Now when we are looking at what we want today, we want a closure in terms of closure to our own lives, closure to the wounds that have still remained green after 25 years. There's no closure to our own lives. Like my mother, she doesn't have a closure to what happened to one of her cousins who was killed. We still don't know who killed her.
So you want acknowledgement and somebody to be punished.
There is denial. There is denial. Because today when they give us these packages, even this government, they look at it like a relief and rehabilitation package. But the package itself, is the nomenclature is so wrong. It has to be called justice, relief and rehabilitation. So you cannot put the cart before the wheel. That's what exactly we want the government to do.
You know, what's interesting when we're hearing voices from the protests emerging was that most of you said that no government, center, state, no one's done for you what all of you expect. And Sunil Khatlani, as a journalist and also a writer from the region, why is it, do you think, that politicians, we saw Omar Abdullah today tweet and say, if this is the kind of ghar vapsi that should happen, but does it ring a little hollow?
No, if this government in place, if Kashmiri Pandits do not get the confidence of returning, I don't know.
You mean when, the central government?
The central government, Narendra Modi. Since Indira Gandhi, Kashmiri Pandits have never thought of a national leader as their own, as much as they think of Narendra Modi. If Narendra Modi is not going to give them confidence to return, I don't know what else can happen. There are 7 lakh.
Are there indicators that he, you know, which have evoked a lot of confidence? I know that the Kashmir elections, they talked a lot about doing things for the community.
Not really. They did not. Quite on the contrary.
If BJP is not...
Hasn't come to that yet.
If Narendra Modi doesn't give us confidence or BJP is not likely to do it, we haven't come to that. I don't think anybody has given up hopes on that.
Everybody is talking about closure. Tomorrow, 21st of January, would be the 25th anniversary of Gaukadil massacre. And the brutality of that massacre, I'm sure not many people know about that. So let's remember those people who were killed in Gaukadil as well. Then only we will have this closure, acknowledgement on both sides. And the brutality with which those people were killed, you will have to, I mean, if you want independent account of it, go and read what William Dalrymple wrote about that massacre. So unless there is this uniform, closure, okay, it's not going to work.
I'll just say, in truth and reconciliation, Sameer, truth has to come before reconciliation. In this case, it's not your pain against my pain. I'm saying government of India obviously should settle, give closure to them, but to us as well.
One small point.
Yeah.
Every time I speak to my Kashmiri Pandit friends, they would tell me that nobody cares about us. People do care about you because that's why we are here. people do not care about Gavkadal because Sunetra is not going to do a program tomorrow on Gavkadal. She is not going to do a program on.
I think Siddharth, come in here as you know, because your words were a little interesting because you weren't there in the protest today, and what you said was very interesting when you said that. When a lot of people talk about going back, you are a little uncertain of that because you say, what is there to go back to? And I want to ask you, there are two sides of the story when we hear, you know, of Kashmiri Pandits. And a lot of the pain that we hear of the Kashmiri Pandits is very bitter because they feel betrayed by the people that are there. Is it? And Samir brings us the other side of the story of the other, you know, the Kashmiri.
And by the way,
Gavkadal
is just one of them.
Yeah.
There have been.
So is it, are they all united by tragic stories like this? Are both communities there united by those stories?
Well, these are contested narratives, and we have to live with the contested narratives. It is just one story. It's a human tragedy what's happened in Kashmir, you know, not just what happened in the 1990, but before that also. But so far as I am concerned, you know, as a, you know, exile, a refugee or a migrant of sorts, I'm just conscious of the sheer absurdity of it, you know, sitting here after 25 years and having to prove that, you know, what happened to us. And then, you know, 25 years is a long time. And it's, I mean, I don't know whose failure it is. Maybe
but
the government
will give you that probe that you want.
No, I mean, we have to prove over and over again, day after day. It's not a question of an anniversary, 25th anniversary, day after day, that, you know, this happened with us, you know. And then what happened was not just what happened with us on one night of 1990 when we left,
sure,
but what continued to happen in the camps.